Understanding the diversification ratio. A crucial metric for portfolio risk management. The diversification ratio is an important metric used by investors and portfolio managers to measure the risk reduction benefits achieved through diversification within a portfolio. Diversification is a fundamental principle of investing that aims to reduce overall portfolio risk by spreading investments across different asset classes, sectors, and securities that are not perfectly correlated. The diversification ratio quantifies the degree to which diversification has reduced the overall risk of a portfolio compared to a theoretical portfolio where all assets are perfectly correlated. It is calculated as the ratio of the portfolio's actual standard deviation to the standard deviation of a perfectly correlated portfolio with the same asset weights. The formula for the diversification ratio is: diversification ratio equals portfolio standard deviation divided by sum of asset weights multiplied by individual asset standard deviations. A lower diversification ratio indicates greater diversification benefits and lower overall portfolio risk. Conversely, a higher ratio suggests that the portfolio is less diversified and thus subject to greater risk. Example: let's consider a portfolio consisting of three assets. Asset A, 20% weight, Asset B, 30% weight, and Asset C, 50% weight. The individual standard deviations of these assets are 10%, 15%, and 20%, respectively. To calculate the diversification ratio, we first need to find the sum of the asset weights multiplied by their respective standard deviations. Sum of asset weight multiplied by asset standard deviation equals 13.5%. Now, let's assume that the actual standard deviation of the portfolio is 12%. Diversification ratio equals 12% divided by 13.5% equals 0.889. An ideal fully diversified portfolio would have a diversification ratio of 0, indicating that the portfolio's risk is completely eliminated through diversification. In our example, the diversification ratio of 0.889 suggests that the portfolio has achieved some level of diversification, reducing the overall risk by approximately 11.1% compared to a perfectly correlated portfolio with the same asset weights. Implications of different ratio values. A diversification ratio of 1 implies that there are no diversification benefits in the portfolio, as all assets are perfectly correlated. This scenario is equivalent to holding a single asset, and the portfolio's risk is equal to the weighted sum of individual asset risks. A diversification ratio between 0 and 1 indicates varying degrees of diversification benefits. The lower the ratio, the greater the risk reduction achieved through diversification. While a diversification ratio of 0 is theoretically ideal, it is often impossible to achieve in practice due to the presence of some level of correlation among assets. However, portfolio managers strive to minimize this ratio as much as possible. Factors affecting the diversification ratio. Asset correlations. The diversification ratio is heavily influenced by the correlations between the assets in the portfolio. Lower correlations among assets lead to greater diversification benefits and a lower diversification ratio. Number of assets. Generally, increasing the number of assets in a portfolio can improve diversification, as long as the assets are not highly correlated. However, beyond a certain point, adding more assets may not significantly improve the diversification ratio. Asset weights. The weights assigned to each asset in the portfolio also affect the diversification ratio. An uneven distribution of weights, with a high concentration in a few assets, can limit the diversification benefits. Monitoring and rebalancing. The diversification ratio should be monitored regularly, as asset correlations and market conditions can change over time, potentially altering the level of diversification in a portfolio. Investors and portfolio managers may need to rebalance their portfolios periodically to maintain an optimal level of diversification. This may involve adjusting asset weights, adding or removing assets, or implementing other strategies to reduce the diversification ratio and enhance risk management. Limitations of the diversification ratio. While the diversification ratio is a valuable tool, it has some limitations. It does not account for potential nonlinear relationships between assets, nor does it consider other risk factors such as liquidity, credit risk, or event risk. Additionally, the diversification ratio assumes that asset returns are normally distributed, which may not always be the case, especially during periods of market stress or extreme events. Therefore, the diversification ratio should be used in conjunction with other risk metrics and portfolio analysis techniques to obtain a comprehensive understanding of portfolio risk and achieve effective diversification. The diversification ratio is a valuable tool for investors to evaluate the effectiveness of their diversification strategies and make informed decisions about asset allocation. It helps identify potential concentrations of risk within a portfolio and guides adjustments to achieve better diversification and risk management. However, it's important to note that the diversification ratio alone does not provide a complete picture of portfolio risk. Investors should also consider other risk metrics, such as value at risk, VAR, and conduct thorough analyses of asset correlations, market conditions, and investment objectives to develop a well-diversified and risk-adjusted portfolio.